Hey, hi, positive readers. It's Binta here today, and I'm vlogging because Broken Throne, the short story collection for Red Queen, is out, and I'm on my way to go get it now. I'm not going to probably read it now. My plan was to go to Barnes & Noble the day it came out, read the short story about Maven, and then leave it in the store because Victoria doesn't deserve my money. But because I'm on time constraints and I feel like it might be some good content in there that I might want to reread someday, I might actually buy it. It's not like a normal book. It's not like $20 or something. It's only like $13. So I might have to finesse. So yeah, we're just going to go get it now. And you know, this whole vlog is just going to be me probably reading it like later on in the day and just probably crying because we all know Victoria hates Maven stands. So I'll see you guys when we're there.
Book has been acquired. It was like way more than I thought it was gonna be, but like, it's fine. It better be worth it. Honestly, Victoria lets me down in every book, but I feel like there could be some good Maven content here, so we're just gonna hope for the best.
So I'm at my internship at the moment, and they don't really have me do anything right now, so I'm gonna low-key take a break and go over to the park and read some of Broken Throne. I'm not gonna read like a lot of it because I feel like I might like spasm and die or something. I don't know, but we're just gonna look through it, you know. And you know, there are those, maybe there are like dividers that have like different story titles or whatever, and I kind of know the story titles, so I don't know. I'm just gonna look through and see. I'm gonna take a break, so meet y'all out there.
So, it's like freaking raining out here, so we're just gonna sit right here up under an awning and see what the hell's up with this book.
Broken Throne.
Enemy brothers. Okay, we're gonna predict what these are. Okay, and I'm shivering because it's cold too. So, I feel like this is Cal. I thought it was Maven, but maybe it's Cal. Enemy brother, we've been new with the Colors. Cal's mom, the Silver Princess, trusts a red captain with her life. I'm not sure who that is. Maybe Farley and a hero, whatever. Probably Mayor Stupid Ass. Okay, so I'm really shivering. It's hilarious. Laugh at me, please. Okay, so that doesn't exist. We're just gonna act like that's not there. We stay in a trilogy, but I do. Never mind. Yeah, whatever, Victoria, okay? Just give me my Maven content, okay? Okay, I think this is like history shit with Julian, which I don't care about at all. Yeah, we're kind of just looking through Queen's Song, which was a freaking novella, which I don't really care about. Something else I don't care about. It looks like Charlotte Guard stuff. I'm just here for Maven. Give me content, please. I'm not out here shivering for nothing. One. What the hell is this? You guys, I paid a whole $20 for this book. They have new characters now? Oh my god, where is Maven? Oh my god, this is tiring. You see this? I'm dying out here. Go back. Okay, this is the Mirakow one. Oh my god, can you just... Shit. Oh. I love how I know that I don't think he's dead, but I love him. What if like she put him at the end? Fuck. I'm gonna cry. Okay, we're stopping. I'm not having a good time. She gave him the last 20 pages. Anyway, that was the sneak peek at Broken Throne. I'm probably going to cut it down because it was like 3 minutes long, but I'm kind of going to cut it down to like the interesting stuff that I said, which is like nothing low-key, but no speak. It's really cold, so I'm going to go back inside, but I'm excited to go home and read this. Like, I'm going to be reading one page and possibly any other page I can find that has Maven's name on it because that's my whole MO with this trash series. So let me go back inside because it's fucking cold.
Hey, I'm home, finally, from work. And so I'm going to be reading this on camera for you guys because I decided to do this on camera, all of it on camera, because first off, it's not like a real novel, it's a short story collection, and I'm not reading all the short stories, so we're just not going to deal with that. But I am going to read Javen's, and you're going to... I'm going to look through all the book, basically just look for his name. Anytime his name pops up, I'm going to, like, read the page. And, you know, whatever. I'm not going to read it out loud, obviously. But, yeah, I just wanted you guys to see my reaction, because I'm probably going to cry on this, just so you know. So, I will be taping this whole thing. First off, a few things. This book's beautiful. If you see it right now, you saw it before, but it's freaking beautiful. Second off, I was looking at the 5 stages of grief in my car when I was on the way home. And the 5 stages of grief are basically what happens after you, like, lose someone or something. And there are the stages that you go through to, like, get over it or whatever. Or maybe not get over it. And basically, the first one was denial. And cause I was thinking about which stage I was in as far as Maven's demise goes. I was trying to see. So I wanted to go see and look, and I went and looked it up, and this is what I found. So the first stage is denial. Basically, you deny it because life is just kind of like, it doesn't make any sense because the person's not there anymore. So you're just like, oh, it didn't happen. So I definitely went through that. I went through that and have been low-key going through that for such a long time. Because, you know, it wasn't definitive in Warstorm that he had died. So I was just like, nah, it didn't happen. You know, I just have been like that for a year. Then the next 8 stage is anger. And basically, it's just like angry at the world, at whatever happened to the person and all that type of stuff. And I definitely would do that too, as you've seen on Twitter or in my Warstorm book chat or anytime I think about or talk about Warstorm. You have seen me be angry over it and over the fact that he ended the way that he did. So, definitely went through that too. The next one, this is when it kind of gets a little bit gray because I kind of low-key just skimmed it and didn't really read the whole thing. But I'm pretty sure like the next one is bargaining. Basically where you're like, oh, you know, if you just bring him back to me, blah, 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 blah. You know, if you just bring them back to me or it back to me, then blah, 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 blah. I'll do whatever you want type attitude or whatever. I guess if you like believe in God, then you'll be asking God, like, if you, I'll just do whatever, if you allow him, let him live or whatever, you know. So basically I kind of went through that because like Victoria, I kind of have been like low-key trying to get her to like appreciate me even more and just being like, just like give us a short story about his life and yeah, I'll be okay or whatever, you know. And then that's number three, I believe. So there were two more. Yes, depression is the next one, and basically it's just like you're just sad. You kind of, you haven't really accepted it, but what you have accepted has made you depressed, and you're very sad about it. And that was me for the entire last part of last year, and I was just really wrecked. I was depressed. I was crying over him, like, every day, every time I thought about him and what happened to him. I was just super sad and crying and not having a good time. And it happened so much, like, just little stuff would trigger me. I reread the first three books, and I would cry, like, during all of them, just because of little stuff, because I knew what happened to him in the end. So, like, just stuff like that, definitely depression, I was through that, too. And now, finally, I feel like I'm at the last stage, acceptance. In my car, I was just thinking, and I have been for a couple months, that what if he really is dead? Would, maybe that will be better type attitude. I have several reasons for this. Sorry if you just came here to watch me read this book, but I kind of want to explain my existence surrounding the character that I like in the series or whatever. So basically, as far as acceptance goes, I think I have accepted that he is dead and that it is a better thing for him now, for me too, because first off, Victoria does not know how to write him. She should not have written such a complex character if she was just gonna basically throw him out of the, like, throw him out to dry or whatever at the end, and basically through the whole series. I just feel like she should have just left it alone and made him basically like the rest of the characters, for one. For two, she did come out and say that him dying in the last book, as we all know, was Cal's choice and Mare's doing. She said that in the last book, they're only human. The characters are only human, and she wrote them like that on purpose so anything that happens doesn't have to be what should have happened. It could just be their human brains and human decisions and human emotions making decisions that may or may not be the best. So basically she's saying that they're gonna have to live with the fact that they killed Maven, even though it might not have been the right thing to do, which we kind of already knew. But like, my whole point is she worded on purpose like that instead of just throwing away his story and ending it prematurely, which, okay, I can kind of low-key vibe with that. That makes me happier because then I don't have to be like, oh my god, you just ended his story because you're a crackhead and don't know how to write. So that's good. I can deal with that. And also, I just think he probably is in a better place now. I think he is. I still believe with every bone in my body that he's not evil and that he was made that way by his mom and that he is in heaven right now, happy, living it up. I just think that he's better off. He was suffering. His mom was constantly in his ear and his brain. He didn't know which parts of him was her, and he couldn't love Cal. All this type of bullcrap. he was suffering and now he's not. So that gives me some closure. Anyway, without further ado, I've been talking for like 5 minutes. We're gonna start reading this freaking book. And let me turn on my song for the series also, that I've listened to every single time I read or reread one of these books. It's beautiful. I love it so much. My family hates me because I play it every single time I reread a book. And when I was rereading the first three, I kind of just reread them in like the same interval. So I kept listening to the song and I hate it now. But I still love this song so much, so I'm gonna read this now. I've so far come across the first two short stories that were already made, like novellas, and then there's one called World Behind, and with this new character, which I definitely don't care about because I don't even care about the old ones. So I'm passing through that, and I think she put him last on purpose. The last one, I'm pretty sure this last one is called Farewell. Like, no wonder she put it last. Jeez. She just wanted to murder us. My heart literally hurts right now, if you know how that feels. Confirmation that he's dead. Love that. For us, you know? Firelight is Mirkow. I will be looking through this, obviously, like the rest of you, to see where Maven's name is. Mary's thinking about whether he could have been saved or not. Crackhead energy. Yeah, he could have. I also have another theory that Maven. You know when I said in my book, I don't know if you even watched it, but if you didn't, in the last scene with him and Mare, they were fighting, and he was, like, choking her, and, like, there was a moment where he, like, pulled back just enough for her to, like, you know, kill him. And basically, I think he did that on purpose, because I really think that he loved her and was obsessed with her way too much to kill her. So he had to make her kill him. I'm gonna off myself. That's depressing. To cry, I'm super excited for the tears. I think I may have made when they were in the room and he went to go see what happened, and he was already dead, but he reached for him before he reached her mirror. Quand tu ris, j'adore. Quand je ris aussi, j'adore. Pourquoi te changer de corps? Et pourquoi c'est comme ça plutôt que le cinéma? Now it's just a what if, you know? Now it's what if he could have been saved? Well, we'll never know because you killed him. I'd be having a better time probably if I see Maven, but probably will be crying, so there's that. This is what happens when your favorite authors, not even your favorite authors, mess up your favorite character and you're just starving for content, and the way you get it, it's just like tears. Aw, they keep thinking about the first book and like stuff that happened in the rooms because they're at the palace. That's depressing. Love that for us. Okay. I'm already crying. Oh my god, I'm reading this. This is... Look at how long it is. Look how short. Okay. We're gonna do it. Trigger for an entirely different reason. Jesus, this series is just, it messes me up inside. If you know, you know, but he calls mom mother too, like just mother, just like not my mother, like just mother, and I'm having a heart attack. Oh my god, bro. I can't see. Pourquoi tu dis rien encore? Vas-y, raconte-moi ton histoire. Dis, j'entends pas bien. Parle un petit peu plus fort. Montre-moi tout ce que j'aimerais voir. Mom was telling him to hurt Cal one last time because Cal was asking him, are you still in there? Like, is there any piece of you left? And he, and basically he was like, he was thinking in his mind, his mom was telling him, you know, hurt him, you know, say something that's gonna hurt him, be like, yeah, it's a part of me in here so that when he kills you, he's depressed forever or whatever. But no, he couldn't bring himself to do it. Jesus. He's not as bad as everybody acts like he is. That's bullshit. And he just acts like the villain that he is. But inside, he really... He can't let baby go, which my heart, you know. That was it. He freak. He just said that he'll never let him go. Say he's sorry. It would just be a double war. So I hope that it's not really over, but it kind of is. But I don't really care about anything else. Had like 4 pages in Maven.
Love that. It's fine. It's fine. I just hope he's happy. Whatever freaking afterlife found him, I just hope he's freaking happy. So that was Broken Throne. Forever story of freaking Aveyard. Hope you enjoyed this freaking depression that I had to go through. Hope you're depressed too if you have any inkling of a brain cell and care about the characters that I do. I can't believe it's over. Guess it was worth it. I mean, I read like on average like 40 pages maybe. But whatever, I'm glad I read it. It didn't disappoint me as much as I thought. Probably won't even review it because it was like 5 pages long. But there's my review right here that you just saw. And turns out, I obviously, if you didn't see that, I did not get the Barnes & Noble exclusive edition that apparently has a whole poster in it that says some stuff about Maven, like basically like a biography of him or whatever. Not a biography, I forgot, but it's kind of like a bio, basically, that basically explains like how tall he is, but stuff like that. And just like little stuff about him, like his favorite foods and stuff like that. We're going to Barnes & Noble to exchange this book. I'm so happy about this. Like, I'm so happy about it. I need it. I'm going to read it for y'all when I get it and tell y'all why it's so important to me. But I need it, and I'm get it, and I'm happy. It's a long story, boys, but we got it. I'll explain when I get home. So basically, on Twitter and a group chat I'm in for Maven, basically they told me and everybody else about in the Barnes & Noble exclusive edition that I just got, there is like a poster thing that has some like facts and stuff about Maven, so I had to go buy that because I kind of made the whole book more worth it than it already was. So, and here we go, here it is. I'm gonna get it out and show you guys. So I don't know how to take it out, but here it is. Basically, just a whole bunch of stuff about him. And I started having a heart attack because basically they sent it to the chat and I read it before I actually bought it. And basically it just talks about like his favorite foods and his favorite stuff to do and stuff that he likes and stuff. And I don't know, it's just like nice. It kind of makes me happy, you know? Yeah, this book basically just brought me a whole bunch of closure that I really needed. Something else in this that really kind of sent me was about how Maven's favorite food is grilled cheese because it's the only meal that his mom made him because he was, despite all her bullcrap, very devoted to his mom. Love that. For us, I'm not having a good time, but I'm not okay. But I am. I'm more okay than I thought it was going to be. So thank you for Victoria for doing this. I really stand. Kind of restored your faith in me. My faith in you. Because it was gone after War Storm. This was my Broken Throne vlog. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you felt the same about this book as I did. Hopefully it could give you some closure or some happiness after the trash that was War Storm. So, see you guys later with another video. Bye.